Hi guys, and welcome back. Well, here I am in Jupiter Farms on a record-setting hot day. It's scorching here. It's supposed to be, I think, 94 today. We've set records the last 2 days, and we'll probably do it again today. But I wanted to take just a second and come out and show you something pretty interesting. Coconuts add an awful lot to the tropical landscape. In fact, when I was a kid growing up in Miami, everybody had tall coconut palms in their yard. A disease came through in the 1970s called lethal yellowing and wiped out all of those palms. They were mostly a variety called Jamaica Talls, and they were replaced with a shorter variety of Malaysian Dwarf or Malaysian Golden, very short palms that grew coconuts when they're very small. You could actually walk up and pick the coconuts off them. But I've got some here growing in my yard. I found something really interesting I'd like to share with you and then to show you a little bit about the coconuts that I've got around here. I'll be right back. I've got to get something. Okay, so this is a coconut that I found growing in a bed in my yard. I hope it's in focus. This is the nut itself, and it was sitting on the ground like this. It's wet on the bottom because I've had it sitting in a container soaking up some water before I relocate it. But there, here you can see the roots coming out, and up here you can see the shoots coming out of the top. So this is how coconuts actually sprout. When you think of coconut palms, you typically think of graceful, tall palms swaying gently in ocean breezes on a white sand beach near crystal clear blue water. But coconut palms aren't native to South Florida, but they can add a great tropical feel to your yard, and they're very easy to grow. Here's one growing in a bed of macho fern underneath some gumbo limbo trees, and these are growing underneath a palm from which they dropped in a fishtail fern bed. Now, coconut palms can get very tall, so if you plant them in your yard, you need to give them plenty of room to spread out, and they are what are called self-cleaning palms. That means they drop the nuts and the fronds, so put them someplace where when things drop, they won't be damaged, like a pool or a patio. They have very few natural pests, although we've had a whitefly infestation in South Florida, which has affected ficus hedges, our native gumbo limbo, and coconut palms. Here's what they look like on emerging fronds in my yard. I control them by cutting off the infected fronds and trying to hose off the bugs with a powerful stream from my hose. So if you want to add a tropical feel to your yard, just get some coconuts from a tall palm and plant them in your yard. You only have to either set them on the ground or put them about halfway in the ground, and they'll sprout and grow. They grow very quickly. These tall ones in my yard are only about 10 years old, and they're probably close to 30 feet tall. Well, thanks a lot for watching. I hope you learned something about coconuts and what they can add to your yard here. I've got quite a few videos on other things here. I've got the tour of my full yard, my full tour of my yard. There's the link to that right there. I've done other ones on Mingarelias, Alocasias, and elephant ears and things like that, so you might enjoy them as well. If you like these videos, you might consider subscribing so you don't miss other ones. I appreciate each and every one of you, and give me a thumbs up down below. I really appreciate it. Till the next video, have a great afternoon.